Hello and welcome to the lecture on graph traversal algorithm implementation using breadth first search algorithm. In this lecture we will be discussing about implementation of graph traversal using breadth first search approach using C programming language. The learning outcome of this video lecture is that the student is able to develop graph traversal using breadth first search algorithm using C programming language. Here the complete implementation, or I can say programming, I'll be dividing into modules. Module 1 is the representation of graph using adjacency matrix, and module 2 is a graph traversal of graph using breadth first search algorithm. Input in the module 1 is the number of nodes in the graph. Second input is the label for each node, and the third input will be the edges present between two nodes or not. If edge present, user will enter one value and 0 for the no edge between two nodes. Output of module 1 is the adjacency matrix of given graph, which will be the input for the module 2. In module 2, set the status of each node to 1. Initialize queue data structure and implement its operations like NQ, DQ, checking queue is empty or not, and then follow the BFS algorithm. Let's start with the module 1. For a given graph G, to represent or to store the information about the graph G, we need input number of nodes and labels for each node. So here in variable declaration section, we have declared N to store number of nodes information and array labels to store label for each node. To store graph information in adjacency matrix, graph G is declared with size 10 by 10 and variable I and J declared for row index and column index. Now to read a number of nodes, prompt message is displayed and scanf statement to read N value. Next, to read labels for each node using for loop, construct in labels array. Within this loop, we have set status array value to all elements to 1. This initialization of status is required to start with breadth first search algorithm. So in the same loop, we are setting the status of all nodes to 1. As shown here in this table, labels array storing label for A, B, C, D, E nodes, and status array value value set to 1 for each node. Here the flush all function is used to clear all buffers associated with input stream, so we can read the node information correctly. Now next is read edge information in a graph and store in adjacency matrix G. An adjacency matrix is used to represent the nodes that are adjacent to one another, that we have already discussed in previous videos. In adjacency matrix, the rows and columns are labeled by graph vertices. An entry in the adjacency matrix G will contain 1 at the ith row and jth column if there is a edge present between these two nodes. As shown here, now to read value in matrix G, nested for loop is used, in which the first loop is for a row index and second loop is for column index. Now you can see here printf statement is given here to ask the user an edge information between two nodes. Here nodes label information is taken from the label in the label array, and then next scanf statement to scan value and store at cell g of ij, that is node at ith row and jth column. Now in undirected graph, we are using here undirected graph, if there is an edge between node A to node B, then there is an edge from node B to node A also. So the value at cell g of ij is 1. It means the value at cell g of ji is also 1. So here we can add one condition, so we can avoid one step of scanning from getting the information from user, and to check that there is an edge means the value 1 at g of ji, then there is no edge, and then else you can have the ji value set to 1. If there is no edge means 0 will be there, and if there is an edge means we can set the value directly to 1 at the cell g of ij. Now here we are displaying the adjacency matrix for given graph. So as we know in two-dimensional array, how we can display the two-dimensional array using nested for loop. The same way we are displaying the adjacency matrix here. Now, in model 2, in which the given graph will be traversed using the by following the BFS algorithm, here input to this model is an adjacency matrix representation of graph, status array and Q data structure. First, variable declaration related to the Q data structure, that is character array Q with size 10 by 10. We are maintaining one more Q here, that is index Q, which is an integer array with the same size 10. Q is also with the size 10, one dimensional array. We will discuss why index Q is required here in the next coming slide. Next, Q front and rear is declared and initialized with 0. And one more variable is declared here is the index, which is initialized to 1. Now, Q operations are NQ, DQ, and checking Q is empty or full. Let us discuss implementation of Q operation. Here, NQ function is defined in this slide. Here, NQ operation is defined to perform NQ operation on a Q, means inserting a new element in the Q with parameters character node and integer node, index I node. In NQ operation, we need to check Q is full or not. So, condition here is to check the Q is full or not. Rare reaches max size means then Q is full. Accordingly, if condition is specified. And if it Q is not full, then we can insert the index information into the Q, and similarly we can insert the node information into the index Q. After NQ operation, increment the rear by 1 to point to the next location. So we are very much familiar with the Q operation. So now let us discuss the implementation of DQ operation, that is a removing element from the queue. Here DQ function is defined which returns the character removed from the queue along with the index position. While DQ operation, we need to check queue is empty or not. So condition here is if front is equal to rear, then queue is empty. So we are not able to remove any element from the queue. So accordingly message is displayed here. And if Q is not empty, then we are removing the node information from the Q, and similarly we are removing the index, that node's index information from the index Q. So this we require index information we require to get the label information about that node. So that's why we are maintaining the index Q separately. There might be the different approach to have the node information and index information in the structure format also. After DQ operation, increment front by 1 to point to the next location and update index Q's values to minus 1 value. Now let us discuss the implementation of checking Q is empty or not. Here is empty function is defined to check Q is empty or not. So if front is equal to rear, then Q is empty. Now we will discuss the BFS algorithm by following this flowchart. Here you can pause the video for some time and write a C code by following BFS algorithm flowchart and using the functions and variables discussed in previous slides. Now we will see the implementation part. So first step in the BFS algorithm is set status 1 for each node in the G. So that we already finished when we are scanning the labels for each node. So we have set the status to 1 for each node in the array status. Then next step is enqueuing the starting node into the queue and update its status to 2. So that's why we are calling here enqueue function by passing the first node information and its index information. So these two will be enqueued into the queue and the index queue, and the status of the first node is updated to 2. Next step we are checking is Q is empty or not. So this while loop is the same one, what it is checking the Q is empty or not. If it is not empty, the block of code will be written here, and if it is empty, then it will be terminated. The program will stop here. It will come out of the loop. So next step in the algorithm, if Q is not empty, DQ a node and process it and set its status to 3. So we are calling here DQ function. So character returned by that we are displaying here as a visited or processed node. And index information, what we are retrieving after this DQ operation. So using that information, the status of that node is updated to 3. Next one is enqueue all the neighbors of the node N which we have dequeued, the neighbors whose status is 1, and then set the status to 2. So for that, using this index information, we are checking this node's neighbors, that is at this column from 0 to N. If that is a neighboring node, means the value in the adjacency matrix is 1 and the status is 1, then enqueue that node information and the index information into the queue and update that node status to 2. So this we are doing repeatedly for all the neighboring nodes of the node which we have just now dequeued from the queue. So this will be repeated, and once you find the queue is empty, your program will come out of the loop. So this is the implementation of the BFS algorithm. So let us see the execution. Till now, whatever we have discussed, the modules in this implementation part of the BFS, let us see the execution part of that particular program. So here enqueue variable declaration, enqueue function, then dequeue function, what we have discussed just now, isEmpty function, main function with the variable declaration, reading number of nodes, read node labels, reading the int information between the nodes. So here the prompt message to ask is there is a edge between these two nodes, then scanf to scan the value in the adjacency matrix, then displaying the adjacency matrix information, and then here from here your BFS implementation starts enqueuing and set first node, then the while loop. So let us execute this particular program. First compile, then run. So here we are following the same example with the 5 nodes A, B, C, D and E. Then we are asking for the edge information. There is no edge between A to A node, so 0 is entered. There is an edge between A to B, A to C, so there is 1 value is entered. Similarly, the edge information between different nodes as taken from the user. So here you can see when once we are asking for A to B, there is no further prompt message to ask from the edge between B to A. So it is considered if there is an edge from A to B, means there is an edge from B to A. This is the adjacency matrix after getting the information about the all edges. And then the by following the BFS node, visited node is displayed here, A, B, C, E, D. So this is the output of the program. Thank you for watching this video.